Zaki set off along the bottom of the little cliff to find a way of climbing up. He was a good climber because he had no obvious hand or footholds. The boulder up ahead might offer some possibilities. The near side of the boulder was smooth and slippery with weed. He walked around it to inspect the other side. Behind the boulder was a dark, low hole in the cliff, a cave. Cave mouth and boulder were so similar in size and shape that the boulder might have served as a door for the cave, if you had a handy giant to roll it into place. Zaki remembered the torch in his fleece pocket, took it out and turned it on. The entrance was little more than his own height, but when he shone the torch in and up, he could see that the ceiling sloped upwards. The walls of the cave were surprisingly smooth, and like the back of the boulder, free of marine life. Zaki stepped inside. How deep was the cave? He shone his torch into the darkness. There was no back wall that he could see. Like the ceiling, the shingle floor of the cave sloped upwards. If he followed the passage, would he emerge through another hole in the rock ledge above? Or did the cave penetrate deep into the hillside? He edged further in, then stopped. He didn't want to be caught by the returning tide. Shining the torch on his watch, he saw it was only 5:30. He had plenty of time. Still, it was unsettling to think that in a few hours this tunnel would be full of water. The deeper he went, the more the cave sloped upwards. It certainly wasn't going to come out through the rock ledge. He must already be inside the hill. The air in the cave seemed a little drier now, and the shingle floor of the first part of the passage had given way to solid rock. Zaki stretched a hand out to the side, but the wall was no longer in reach. Dropping the torch beam, he saw that the rock floor ahead had been cut into a flight of rough steps. Someone, at some time, had gone to a lot of trouble. This was more than just a cave. Perhaps a secret passage. A smuggler's den, Zaki pressed on quickly. The first flight of steps led to a long flat section and then more steps. He must be above the level of the rock ledge, above the high tide line. This part of the cave would never flood. Reaching the top step, he shone his torch ahead. A wall! The light reflected back at him off solid stone. Was this the end? Maybe the passage led off to the left or right. At first, he felt disappointment. A smuggler's passage should have led to a hidden panel in an ancient inn, or to a trap door in the crypt of a village church. But of course, there were no villages for miles. He began to explore the walls. Perhaps there was a cleverly pivoted rock that would swing aside when pushed. Working his way around the walls, searching for cracks, he failed to notice the rock platform that jutted out below knee level until he caught his shin hard on the jagged corner. The shock made him let go of his torch, which fell onto the platform and rolled a short distance before coming to rest against something white.